media, literary culture, and society. It's a great honor to be invited here. So it's a great thanks to the President, Secretary, Principal, IQC Coordinator, Head of English Department, and all sorts. It's not a lecture that I'm going to deliver on certain topics. We read literature. Through literature, we come across a number of stories. Regionally, stories differ. State-wise, stories differ. Internationally, stories differ. But the concern is the same. Although there are lots of differences that we can see, an American woman is different, an Indian woman is different. And literature demonstrates the realistic picture of the society. What about media, films? Wherein also we come across the realistic picture of the society. Sometimes the reality portrayed through films is more, and sometimes it's less. It's a high time on the part of students to gear up and accelerate our vision, ideas, progression for success. There is a discrimination, male, female. It's a creation of God. In Christianity, Adam and Eve story, that is well familiar. You are quite well familiar with Adam and Eve. My question is, suppose there is the progress of a woman, does a man feel insecure? Does a man feel insecure for the progress of a woman? Different views are there, right? Someone will say yes, someone will say no. It will lead to debate and all these things. This issue is debatable. Argumentations may be there. But in my presentation that I am going to start very soon, so there are some presentation slides are there, videos are there. So I will show you what I think about this issue. But my concern is that all are equal. There must not be any discrimination between man and woman, male and female. Because God has created, first, it's a Nishay who says the creation of a woman is the second mistake of God. The first mistake is, so here, it's very difficult for a man to understand a woman. And equally, it's very difficult for a woman to understand man. This is extreme level of complexities of the mind. That's why William Shakespeare said, there is no art to find my satisfaction in the face of a gentleman on whom I built an absolute trust. The intricacy of the mind has not yet fathomed. No one can understand the mind. So that's why it is said that it's very difficult to understand a woman. I am a married person. It's very difficult to understand. It's very difficult to measure the depth of ocean. It's very difficult to know the intensity of fire And it's very difficult to know the nature of a woman. Because she plays different roles. She is a child, she is a daughter, wife, mother. And while performing different roles, the nature goes on changing. Whom we like the best? If asked, this question is asked to each and every person, whom we like the best, we may say that I like very much my mother. Why? It's very wife and husband, that's a different thing. That relationship is different. Because whatever I say through this seminar, I need to be very careful, because something should not go here and there. Because we are very keen to listen to what exactly it is being said. So here, it's very difficult to fathom the intricacy of the mind of a woman. So,
sir,
it's
my
laptop is there. Sir. My laptop.
Are you there? Hi.
Okay. This male ID you can open. It's on male ID. For women empowerment. Stages of women empowerment. Stages 6, yes, for women empowerment. Ways to achieve women empowerment. Constraints of women empowerment. Changes of empowered women. Measurement of women empowerment. Projects for women empowerment. Acts for women empowerment. There are so many things. What exactly empowerment means? Look at the title of the seminar, which is very crucial. First, women empowerment, a fusion of media, literary, culture and society. This might be better. Oh, it's good. I find very difficult. I want to keep this here. Yes, you hear me. Okay, nice. The first and foremost thing that I would like to talk about, empowerment. Look at the word EM plus power plus MEMT. What is the crux of the matter is that power, giving power to someone, to whom we give power. We give power to the person who is powerless, who is vulnerable, who is being harassed, employed, exploited. If we ask a question to a woman, can you please express your ideas through writing about your own suffering, endless, ceaseless, incessant suffering of your life? It's a woman who has immense tolerance. She tolerates things. Right? And it's a man who is very wrathful, who is very angry. His nature is totally different. It's okay that there are differences in nature, temperaments, but still, literature is a way through which emotions, feelings, suffering, all these things are expressed or revealed. Literature is the revelation of different temperaments. Because we judge a person on the basis of socio-economic status. Right? Suppose I have full money, right? I am very, very rich. My standard is different. Here we are talking about society. Right? Through seminars, we only talk
we never find out any solution of the problem. Do we? Never. Through books, we discuss things about rape, we discuss things about sexual harassments during office hours and all these things. But we never find out the solution of the problem. Just a simple example I want to give you. I was in Maldives. Very simple example. Example is not so important, but the message is important. A beautiful thing is there. There is one fridge is there, and Indians used to work in Maldives. They just take up the bottle of water, they drink and keep it on the fridge, water, empty bottle. And they go out. Every day the situation is the same. But what happens in the course of time is that next day we found one notice there. Indians may say that don't keep bottles on the fridge. This is the instruction by Indians. We always use the word don't do this, don't do that, right? But we never talk about what to do, right? Solution is more important than problem. Suppose I say, please tell me the problems in India, I may fall down on the ground. Because you may give me thousands of problems in India, employment and all this, unemployment, many, many baker problems, all problems, the road is not there, electricity is not there, women problems there, suffering is there, rape and everything. Means we come across thousands of problems in India. But have you ever thought of the remedy of the problem, the solution of the problem? So what they did in Maldives is that they wrote one, they kept one empty box wherein it was written, do not, please keep empty bottles here. Is they gave the solution of the problem. So what I mean here is that man should struggle for the solution. Because a woman is the product of God. Man is the product of God. You agree, God or no, I don't know. This is the creation. We have to agree. Because man cannot master over his own death. He doesn't know anything about his own self. Just he thinks inwardly in order to aware his presence spiritually, intellectually. See, who is the most powerful person? One who knows himself or herself spiritually is the most powerful person. This is my own definition. I have not taken any this definition from any writer. This is my, what I feel. That you can get yourself empowered only through spirituality. So here is a question of social equality. Right? Man says, I am the first, and she says, you are second. And she says, no, I want to be equal. Right? The question is that man and women are the two wheels of the vehicle. Both are important. Both things are important. So there must not be any discrimination. These days, the picture of a woman is different. She is going out. Right? You cannot find a woman within the four walls of the house. Only to cook and produce children, look after the children. This is her daily or household work. So can you see a man in the kitchen cooking and a woman is outside in her office? See, look at one thing. I'm talking about freedom. She is also a human being, man is also a human being, right? There should not be any discrimination. Suppose if we switch something and clean something, this is not my duty. Cooking is not my duty. right? I am also not the exception for all these things, because I talk about many things. But here what happens, we have some social restrictions, obligations from where the redemption is impossible. So here, my concern is that, suppose a small girl is there, my son is there in the family, there is one family. How we treat them? Do we give everything to the daughter? No. Why? She is a daughter. And boy, we give so much of importance. Daughter, one day you will get married and you will leave the house, your husband will take care of you. Because a woman suffers endlessly from her birth to death. This is true. And men also agree with this. It's true, because we see, we witness things. But still, what kind of freedom she wants? What is the restlessness within her? Does a woman want to surpass man's intelligence? No. What exactly she demands? Many issues are there. Because each and every writer, a feminist writer, talks about her suffering through novels, through short stories, through myths. I think you might have learnt about Girish Karnad's Nagamandala, Vishakha, Rani, Padmini, the characters. What are the characters? Characters mean simply a demonstration of the actuality, the reality of the society. Pictures, the same thing. At the end of my lecture, I will show you one video. This video will change your minds. Total minds. Because the video is not from India. This is from abroad. So whatever the people say, the white people say, we agree with them. We call something as superstition, and the same superstition will be changed if the foreigners say that this is not superstition, there is a science behind it. Then we feel that, yes, this is. But in India, everything is there. We go for things rationally, intellectually, spiritually, at different levels, and we interpret things. So here, my concern about empowerment, what exactly empowerment means. Empowerment refers to the increasing the spiritual, political, social, or economic strength of individuals and communities. See, look at the words, increasing of spiritual, political, social, or socio-economic strength of individuals. Individual has her own dignity, status in the society. So as we see that, here as a general definition, empowerment is a multidimensional process that helps people gain control over their own lives. It is the process and the outcome of the process by which women challenge gender-based discrimination in every institution and structures of the society. What we need to change? A structured society, a hierarchical society. In those days, there is Swayamvara, you know, Swayamvara. Choice. It's a choice of a woman. What? I don't want to marry this person. I want to marry this or that. It's her own choice. These days, the system is changed. Here, bride, this parents decide. This person is good for you. And in this way, we can find the genes. We talk about the Ramayana, we talk about the Mahabharata, we talk about the female characters, we abuse them. We think that woman is responsible for Mahabharata and Sita and all these things. We make some own argumentations and our decisions and our remarks. But what I feel about this issue is that we cannot make someone responsible for something, because everything has already been pre-planned, executed in order to fight adharmas, right? So as you know, because that topic is different, that adharma plus adharma is equal to dharma. 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. Right? So here, what I want to say that I want to generate the feelings of equality among you all. So here, the meaning is interpreted. Just have a look at this meaning. Women empowerment means freedom of women from vicious grips of social, economical, political, caste and gender-based discrimination. Every society is different. In different societies, women are differently treated. Sometimes they are harassed, beaten. And we find the role of the law and order. Breaking laws is the law in India. Because laws are broken, most of the time. Then we cannot find the remedy of the things. Look at the words here. Women empowerment refers to social rights governed by law, political rights, economical stability, judicial strength, and other rights. The same thing is that a woman is equal to a man. Swami Vivekananda says. Let's see what he says about this. There is no chance for the welfare of the world unless the condition of women is improved. It means we are talking about vulnerability, suppression, depression, constraints, socio-economic deterioration. It's a fall from our own eyes. Aishwarya Roy, Indira Gandhi. If we name a few, Kiran Bedi, or many from your states as well. So we feel proud about them. Why? Because they have liberated themselves from the restraints, constraints of the society. And they have proved themselves how they are much better and what they can do. Because the spirit in a man and a woman is equal. There is no discrimination. The mind is the same. It's a mentor who says, mind is in its own place, it can make heaven hell and hell heaven. Right? And the intricacy of the mind has not yet been understood. So here, my concern about this is that, the key word is that, the condition of women is improved. Unless the condition of women is improved. This is the key phrase, clause. The condition of a woman must be improved in the society. Then only there is the welfare of the world. He is talking about the welfare of the world. He is not talking about India. See, if you think of the foreign woman, is she happy? Do you think that she does not have any problem? Yes, she has also many problems. Because a woman has to undergo through the same phases of life. Maybe she is from London or America or India or whatever the country she is from. That never matters. Yes, there are small changes out there. Laws are different. restrictions are not there, but what about feelings, emotions? They are the same. That cannot be changed all over the world. So here, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India, talks about the condition of a woman on empowerment. What exactly empowerment? I have already said EM plus power plus ment. Power is verb, EM is prefix, and ment is noun, prefix, suffix, giving power. What kind of power? All socio-economic and spiritual things. So here, when women move forward, the family moves, the villages move, the nation moves. Actually, grammatically we can say that nation moves, it should be moves. So it is written move. The nation is used as plural. Maybe Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru wants to say nations move. So here, look at this sentence. It's very important. Whenever women move forward, there is the movement of the family onwards, the movement of villages onwards, nations ahead. It means it is very relevant for the progression of life. What is the status of women in Indian society? What exactly it is? The first and foremost thing that Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru said in this regard is that in order to awaken people, it is the people who have to be awakened. Once he moves, the country moves, thus we build the India of tomorrow. In India, the problems of women have never been eradicated. If I ask a simple question, because in this seminar I find 80% women and 20% men. Right? Not 80. 90% women plus 10% men. It means empowerment of women. Very simple. Right? Because as I have been invited here as the chief guest, I must talk something good about women. Okay? I have to return back. I have to go back safe and sound to my place. Right? Because these issues are quite burning. These issues are quite burning issues. But what I feel is that I don't say that 100% solution should be given to the problem. I don't say that. But at least 5%, 10%, start giving solution to the problems. Is there any solution to the problem of fire burning? Is there any solution to the problem of dowry deaths? Traditionally, it has been happening, but nobody has ever stopped. And no one will stop this. In future also. Rapes, so many things you can see every day. Sexual harassment, I am going to show you one video of sexual harassment at the end of my lecture. The end of lecture, so the video is for 29 minutes, no, not 20 minutes. Last 20 minutes. Just please remind me about the video because you should keep some time for that. So where you will understand what exactly a woman feels and what exactly she needs. Because what happens, everyone as the human being, everyone has dreams. You have dreams? What is a dream? Kalam, you know this, what he says? Dream never means what you see when you sleep and sleep. This is not a dream. Dream is that which never lets you sleep. This is very important. That is dream. If I ask the question to each and every girl here sitting here, what's your dream? She may say, I want to become a doctor, or I want to become this and that, engineer and all this, mentor. And what about the dream? In the course of time, the same dream gets shattered. Why? Because of social constraints, social obligations, So this fixed hierarchy of the society, this stiff society, this stereotypical society needs to be changed in order to bring positive, visible changes. What is education? Most of the students ask me this question. Sir, could you please answer me, what is education? I simply give three words. Positive, visible changes. In the society, what we need? Positive, visible changes. In the society, in order to change the society, we need to be changed ourselves. We need to be an instrument of change. It's very easy to deliver lectures, but it's very difficult to change ourselves. First, what is important for this issue is that we need to change ourselves only when the society will, you will find some gradual changes in the society, radical changes in the society. Society is not going to be changed. It is to be changed. We need to change it. We need to be the instrument of change. Then only this can change. So here, this is a very key message that we can find here about this. So we want to make the India much better. See, it is also said that Indians are emotionally fools for importance. They are very emotional, sentimental compared to others. If we think of, for example, if a child cries in London and the woman is in India, she can feel the cry of the child. In foreign countries, do they feel? They also feel, but a bit. But we, 100% women feel. Because in Sanskrit it is said, mama vedana plus tava vedana is equal to samvedana. Mama vedana means, mama means my. Vedana means suffering. My suffering plus your suffering is equal to samvedana. There is no word for samvedana in English. In English, the word is sensation. Sensation means sense in motion. And what is sense? Sense means our perception, our thinking, touch, and all this. Five senses. Right? Here, it means we are very sentimental. We are very emotional. We have feelings, emotions, and all this. If I say something wrong, suddenly the our eyes get watered, tears roll down. For foreigners, if you say something, they no tears and nothing else. They are very rigid internally. And we want to become like that. So, when we can achieve such goals, only then if we leave our house or home and go outside. So, India is now in transition age. Present country is knowledge century era. A knowledge-driven generation will be an asset for the progression and development of the nation. To achieve and sustain the high growth rates, access in education should be open for entire population without any discrimination. As women are the dynamic promoters of social transformation, this empowerment and education is must. What is important? The key word is social transformation. And women must be the instrument of change and the dynamic promoters. Suppose today, in a male-dominated society, 60% male are dominant and 40% women. Suppose 60% women are dominant and 40% male are different. Suppose like that. The government is given to the women. What changes you will find in thinking and action and all this? Sometimes, most of the times, the administration of women is more powerful than men. administration. Most of the times the males, they do not make decisions properly at proper times. They may ask for help to their wives. So I am not going in detail for all these things because this may take so much of time. This is women's status in India, that we have already gone through this. Then in ancient India, what exactly the status is that? During this period, women had high social and religious status. See, one thing, I love all religions in the world. What? I like all religions in the world. In my personal opinion, I love human beings. I never discriminate man and woman. I like human beings. One. So here, if you give much more importance to a woman, it's very important to empower her and maintain her socio-religious status in the society. Just look back the past. Look back in the past. I think you have already studied the Ramayana, Mahabharata, Vedic literature and all this. There is sufficient evidence in Vedic literature that in Vedic period, women were imparted Vedic education and used to take part in religious rites. Shani Shinnapur, have you heard the name? Where women are not allowed for the darshan of Shani Deva. And one of the women entered inside, she took the darshan, came out, the media caught her and news are there and all. It means we believe in the religion we are born and brought up. What's culture? Suppose I were born in Tamil Nadu. My different is like, my language is like you. My culture is like you. My thoughts are like you. When I came here, I asked one question, that is, are you a vegetarian or a non-veg? I am not against non-veg. You may ask me a question, why I ask this question? This is irrelevant. This is not irrelevant, this is relevant. Why? Because what you eat depends on what you think. What you think depends on how you behave. How you behave depends on what your character is. I am not against non-veg eaters. So vegetarian, in Marathi it is said, Shuddha Shakari Ahar Acharan. You know Marathi here, anyone? Nobody knows Marathi. Marathi kunalai mahit nahi? Nobody knows Marathi. English you know. My mother tongue is Marathi. Marathi is my mother tongue. English is other tongue. Most of the times we feel very comfortable in our Marathi, but I feel very comfortable in English. Marathi is my mother tongue because it is taught by the mother. Mother is the first teacher and the teacher is the second mother. But my point, one thing I would like to say, one example. Just I was in the classroom, I came out. One girl was standing there. She has an umbrella in her hand. It was raining cats and dogs. I want to go to that side. I just requested a woman, that girl, sorry, could you please give me your umbrella? I want to go to that side, please. She said, it's a lady's umbrella. Then I say, rain doesn't know whether it's ladies or gents. there is also discrimination. Example is very simple, but through which we learn things. I mean discrimination. Look at the same, this boy and girl in your family only, how we treat them. If we are not able to treat them properly, no use of organizing seminars. Decide today that you are going to equally treat men and women in my family, then this seminar will be a grand success. I don't want 100% change in the society. What I want is 10% change. So change is always in a gradual state of things. So here, that I am talking about religious things. This religion is the point and I forgot about religions. What is religion? The best and the... There is only one religion in the world, that is humanity. Humanity is the only religion in the world. So, my question is that, is it a man-made disaster or natural disaster? Discrimination. It's a man-made disaster. Because it's a society, we have created our own rules, we have dominated things, and we do such things. So here, women of that age were capable of learning and understanding philosophical doctrines. In Vedic age, women remained unmarried for higher studies. See, this is their ambition. The women education has been highly appreciated in Atharva Veda. Women education has been given much importance in Vedas. Man emphasized that it was the duty of parents to give her daughters internal integral education. However, there was a gradual decline in female education during later Vedic period. So, just by the crux of the idea is that in every phase, the treatment given to the women seems to be different and it goes on changing in the course of time. So, next I will tell. Before 20 minutes, please let me know, okay? Still continue, but still I will take 10 minutes, then I will say.
No break.
No break. So how long am I supposed to take now? Is there any woman that wants to express her own problems in the society? Any? Can anyone speak on this issue? What problems you feel at present? Just speak up. Yes.
Hello.
The solution of the problem is that we don't have proper law and order in our country.
Yes.
One mic.
Yes, get it.